cone has been cut to create a parabolic curve. What we're asked to do in part A is draw the given front elevation on the plan. I'm then going to quickly go through part B, which is developing the conical surface. And then I'm going to mostly focus on part C, getting the true shape of the parabola PV and getting the position of the axis in the focus. So what I've done so far is I've set up the top cone. And what I'm going to do next now is put in the cutting plane that's in the question. So I'm getting this angle here, bringing it across, drawing in this line. That line is parallel to this line, and we're told that in the question. So parallel symbol is shown inside the question as well. Okay. With that done then, our job is to now try and get this curve, which starts here, curves around, comes back up to here in plan. And the best we're going to achieve that is with horizontal cutting planes. So I'm setting myself up, I can use your t-square anyway, but parallel to my xy axis. And I'm going to draw in one of the cutting planes. Now the position of the cutting planes and the amount you put in is irrelevant. Once you have enough in to actually draw the shape. So that's one of the horizontal cutting planes in. And I've set my compass so that I'm going from the middle of the cone to the sloped edge of the cone, so that is my radius. And then I draw that circle one time. So this red line here looks like this red circle down in plan. Where that red line intersects the slope, which is here, I now have a point on my parabola. I can now bring that vertically straight down, and I can find the points down in plan on the circle. Here, and here. And I repeat the process. I just keep putting in more horizontal cutting planes to get more points down in plan. So again, parallel to my XY, I'll draw in a horizontal cutting plane. From the centre of the cone to the outside of the cone, I get a slightly bigger circle this time. And I'll put that down here in the middle of the plan. Draw the circle around. Again, this line here appears as this outside red circle on the plan, where the red circle crosses over the cutting plane. I set myself up and I bring down this pipe into plan also. I got another two dots. One more time. Set myself up. Go very low this time. Again, horizontal cutting plane. So this circle will be smaller down in plan. I go from the center to the outside, smaller radius. I go down the plan, and I draw that circle. When the two of these intersect each other, I bring that point down as well. And I get another two points on the smaller circle. These two points here are also points on the curve, which you'll see in the question. So now I just need to get one more point, which is the lowest point, and that would be a very particular circle. It goes through this point here, right down at the very bottom. So I'm going here, I'm going to draw and dot it so it appears slightly different. Still a horizontal cutting plane, it's just the lowest horizontal cutting plane. I still set my compass to that size of a circle, so it's still a smaller size. Point my compass in the middle, pencil to the outside, and I draw that circle around the plan. That circle I'm going to draw a dot as well because I drew a dot along with the elevation. Where this corner is here, I can bring it down. And you'll see it'll be just on the outside edge of the circle, the east point of the circle. draw a horizontal line either across the object, finds the exact same point. So this here is the lowest turning point on the curve. When you have enough dots got and you're happy, you join them up freehand to create the parabolic curve. So that's that curve in the question got going from P right around here. Next thing to do now is to get the ball or the focal sphere so that I can answer part C so I get the focal point. So I know that the focal sphere has to be somewhere along this center line. The next thing, just like in the last video, I have to bisect the angle between the cutting plane, which is this line here, and the side of the cone. So basically, I am bisecting this angle here that I'm shading in now. Very same as last time, bisect an angle. I set the compass any angle I like, draw an arc. I then set larger if I want, half the x, half the x, and you'll have your bisector in place. Where that crosses over the center line, that is the middle for your sphere. Put the point of the compass there, pencil on the outside, and you can draw in the ball. If you want to get the exact radius and the exact position of the focal point, just set yourself up with the long side of the set square against the cutting plane, which is now a tangent. Flip your set square. And you can draw a line that goes from the center across. That's a normal to the tangent. And where that normal crosses over the cutting plane, we'll find the exact position of the focus. Right there. I'm not going to get the true shape of the cut surface. So, just like in the video where we did the lipstick question, I set myself up alongside against the cutting plane. Flip my set square, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring out all these points that we've got while establishing the curve down here. So I'm going to label them quickly. I'm going to call this one here V. I've already got focus. I'm going to call this one here 2. I'm going to call this here 3, 4. I'm also going to label down a plan. So that's 4 and that's 4. This is 3 and 3. 2 and 2, and this is B here. Bring the points out. So, bring out V. I can bring out the focus. I can also bring out 2. I can bring out 3. Wherever I like, I set up an XY line just outside my drawing. And then just like the last time, the last question, if I go from my XY to 4, I go from this XY to 4. If I go from this XY to 4 on the far side, I'll go from this XY to 4 on the far side. That finds 2 points. Same here, this XY to 3. Maybe this XY to 3. This XY to 3 on the far side. Will be this XY to 3 on this side. That finds the position of 3. This XY to 2. That's this XY to find 2. This XY to the far one. So I'm getting this distance here from the XY down to the far point. Will be this XY to the far point. So that finds 2. And then finally, this XY to V will be this XY to V. And that is a freehand curve. Now, you really should be getting more points rather than what I just have. What would be incorrect to do at this point is to draw something like this. Yeah. No. There should be a curve happening going around by V. So, I've left out one line that I brought out here. If I was to get them next 2 points, you'd see the curve widens as it gets close to the turning point and goes back up through sight. It'll rarely be a situation if it's a parabola that you want to have something up to a point like this. So that answers part A and part C of the question. So you've got the true shape of the parabola, you've located the focus. To find the focus out here, I just bring out the focus, and then I go 90 degrees to that line, or parallel to the x1, y1, whichever one you want to pick, they're both the same. And I can draw the axis which goes through point B. That basically divides the shape up symmetrically. Axis, and the line coming down from the focus, where it crosses the axis, that finds the focus out here. Okay. Now, the development of the cone, just to do it very, very quickly. If you extend the sides of the cone onto the meet each other, yeah, that would be where the top of the cone would be if it was a full shape. You can then put the point of your compass at the apex of the cone that I've just got, pencil up at the top, and somewhere where you have space, it doesn't matter really too much where, you can draw in a arc. And that's where the point of my compass was, and I can draw in a flat line. The next thing now is to find where does this arc end. Okay? The best way of doing that is to create a division on your circular in plan, on your cone in plan, so you can go just with one 30 degree segment as loads. And you take the distance of one of those. So it's going to be an approximation of the length of this here. If I was to fully divide this up by 30, 60, it would be 12 equal spaces. So I'm taking one of them, and I'm going to mark off 12. That would be if it was a full cone. Basically, if I was to cut this fan shape out and roll it up, I'd end up creating this full cone. But the cone has been cut. So the XY has cut it, some of it off, so that much has to come off next. Again, this length of my compass, the apex that's missing, and I'm drawing in that arc. So now if I was to cut out this, all of this, so this fan shape without this section here rolled up, I would get the cone before the parabola was taken out of it. I'm going to draw on a few construction lines now from the apex out to each of the divisions. I'm only going to go halfway as well. Because as far as I'm concerned, if you can get half of what's going on here, you can just mirror it over the other side with tracing tape or the other half. So the cone has been cut. I'm going to very quickly just put in half of the divisions onto this. Just finish them up, but only on the front half. That'll be enough for this program or for the video. So again, going over my 30, 60 set square. I'm going to bring these points where they finish on the outside of the cone up in the front elevation. Now the good news is once you get two of these, it's repetitive because it's symmetrical shape. So, 1, 2. The center one's already gone up, so that's that. So I'll call this here point A, that's A, I'll call this here. progress C. This here is C times 4. Okay. I'm now going to join B, C, and A back to the apex. The reason why is because these lines, these points, represent these lines I've got here. And A is already going back. Now, this is where there's a lot of mistakes in the textbooks, because what the textbooks do is, well, some of them, not all of them, they take the position from here to the cutting point, and they map it straight onto this, which is incorrect. We have to find the true length of two lines now in order to finish the question off. We have to find the true length from the cutting plane here down to the apex, and from the cutting plane here down to the apex. Those two lines that I've just drawn a little bit heavier. Those two lines are these two lines down in the plan. The point B to the apex and the point C to the apex. So B going to the apex, C going to the apex, but not all the way. They're starting here where it hits the parabola and here where it hits the parabola going back. So it's just this much of the line apex B and this much of the line apex C. I'm going to look perpendicular to both of them down in plan. Set up a new XY line up to one side. Now, you could use rebatments to solve this. Absolutely perfectly fine to use rebatments. But I think using auxiliary views is much more important for other topics. So you may as well stick with one principle and practice it out well. So from this XY up to where it hits the cutting plane, would be from this XY up to where it hits the cutting plane. And that there would be the true length of one of the lines we're looking for. And equally the next one, we want to look perpendicular to it. So again, out of 90. Set the new XY. Same thing. So there's two true lengths established. I'm going to use these true lengths then in order to find points on this particular shape. See happening is when we join them up, we end up creating a curve happening here. Okay, so if you want to finish the development off, you can. I will be more so focused in the video on getting them to draw the front elevation, the plan, the focus sphere, and getting the true shape. Okay, thank you.